trabalho de Sunday no mais frio do week. I'm all alone. My kid left with her dad already. She didn't want to go, but you know how it is. She's feeling really better thanks to the new medication that was given to her. She hasn't scratched at all. Her skin looks a little bit clearer, so I'm happy about that. Tomorrow is the last day for her medication. It was only 10 pills that she had to take in 5 days. So tomorrow's the last two. Then she can take an antihistamine a day, which is the Claritin. I gave my ex the pills. She has a doctor's appointment tomorrow to the dermatologist so they can further look at her skin. I gave my ex her insurance card, her social security. I gave him the appointment. I gave him her medication. I'm hoping that he can pull through, you know, and do a job that requires him to be done. Hope he could be a parent for tomorrow. He looked really confused as I was giving him the medication. Her pills, their last two pills are pretty big, and then the Claritin, the little antihistamines, they're really small. So she could take one a day. She's gonna be with him for 3 days, so she gets 3 pills. She has to take 2 pills tomorrow that are the last of the, I guess they're like some kind of antibiotic or something that are, you know, cleaning her from the inside out, getting all that infection and that eczema flare up away. My ex looked very confused. I feel like I had to draw him a schematic or something so he can understand what pill goes where. I told him, listen, before you give her anything, if you feel really, really confused, call me, okay? Don't give her all the pills at one time. I'm so scared for my kid. I hope he can follow directions. Oh my god, I would fucking have a titty attack if something happened to my kid in this man's care. I will skin him like a cat. So he is very sick. My ex is very sick right now. He looks really, really bad. I don't know what's wrong with him. His face is kind of sunken in, and his eyes are sunken in. He's like all sweaty and stuffed up and coughing, and he looks really, really bad. I think he's really sick. I hope my kid doesn't catch whatever he has. We didn't really say much. It was kind of like a rushed conversation, and you know, my kid had to go. She took, she has a little PlayStation 2, which is rather old. And unfortunately, that game console has seen better days. So lately it's been cutting off, and all the discs are scratched and stuff, and my kid's really frustrated. And then I have this very old desktop. It's not so slow, but for some reason the CD-ROM drive, sometimes it'll open and sometimes it won't open. So I mean, I can't just press the button and the thing opens. I mean, I have to like bang it and beg and fucking give it offerings and shit, like, please open. And it opens when it wants to. So she gets frustrated too, because she wants to play computer games on there. So you could just imagine, she got so frustrated yesterday. She was back and forth from the desktop to the PlayStation, and I mean, they were each giving her problems. And so she just got fed up and stopped in the middle of the living room and was like, Mommy, can we just go get a Nintendo Wii? Like, I promise I will do better in school. Just please, can we just get a Wii? I mean, come on, Mommy. There's nothing to do in this house. I felt so bad for her. I felt like really going to go and get one. I don't know. We had an agreement, you know. She has to pull her grades up, and then I could get her a Wii and a bunch of games and all these things. But you know, I can't go back on that. Trust me, this is killing me too, because I would love nothing more than to play video games all day. Especially Nintendo. God, I used to, my goodness, I used to get really, really stoned and then just be all night until like the next day, and I hardcore insomniac, so I would go days just on the fucking video game console. Back then, I was a huge Zelda fan. Oh my god. Ocarina of Time is the shit. And I was hooked on Resident Evil and Animal Crossing. Oh my god. You could not get me off of Animal Crossing. And then you had like Animal Crossing for the DS until it was like a crossover thing. And so I would leave the console at home, but then I had the DS until the fucking gameplay continued. So yes, it's killing me as much as it's killing her, because I would love nothing more than to sit in front of a TV screen until I have a seizure from staring at pixelated images of anime and poorly drawn cartoons. So yeah, I feel bad for her. But yeah, she has to pull those grades up. I can't go back on that. Her birthday is coming up next month. Maybe we get it by then. My sister, I'm gonna go see her next month. I requested time off. I'm gonna leave Thanksgiving for us Americans. It falls on November 22nd of next month, I believe. It always lands on the last Thursday. My kid's birthday is November 26th. Sometimes her birthday falls on Thanksgiving, sometimes it doesn't. So what I did was, I usually work Monday through Wednesday, and some days I'll work Thursdays or Fridays and stuff. I haven't worked a Friday in like a week or so. So my sister really wants me to go up there. I usually am always up there every Thanksgiving, so it's like, I guess it's like a tradition now. So you know, I go up there, I cook Thanksgiving for the family, we buy a tree, we decorate the tree all together. We do my kid's birthday. We do this thing where we go to this part of Orlando, downtown Orlando. And we go to this place called Old Town. And it's Old Town because it's just these old colonial buildings. It's really, really neat. And usually around the time that we go, there's like car shows and things, like really classic cars. People like Fast and Furious cars, but like decked out old classic cars. It's really, really nice. And you know, we have like a little routine, I guess you could say. You know, we go bike riding, we go to the park, we do all these things together. It's really, really sweet. We spend a lot of time together. I love the times that I go up there because I get to be with my family, you know? Like, all of us really hang out together. Well, my sister now feels very lonely, you know, because the kids all do their own thing. You know, my nephew has basketball. My other nephew just got into basketball now, so they're both always playing basketball or at some game or something. And, so my sister is by herself. Her husband works odd hours. Like, he'll work morning to like midnight or something. He's just gone all day. And so she's pretty much alone for the majority of the night. And kind of like me. And it's very lonely. Like, it's very lonely, I can imagine. Well, I know, actually. So it so happens that when I go up there, it's very different. I don't know. We're all together, all of us. And I love spending time with my nephews. When that happens, I mean, they stop whatever it is that they're doing, and we're all together, and that's really nice. So I can't wait to go up there. She's really excited. She kept pestering me all week, please request the time off, get the time off, get the time off. And I finally told my manager the other day, I'm like, listen, I need the 22nd until like the 24th off. You know, I can't be scheduled for any of those days. I'm gonna be out of town. So I have the time off, so I'm gonna leave the day before Thanksgiving, possibly at night. I'm gonna catch the bus up there with my daughter, and then Thanksgiving Day, I'm gonna cook. Of course, I'm the designated cook. Everyone gains weight when I go up there. I feed everyone. Everyone just eats and kind of lounges in front of the TV for a couple hours, and then it's kind of like a repeat. And then at night, everyone gets drunk and we all just laugh and talk shit or play video games or something. And then, you know, we go. My sister actually wants to do something different this year. She wants to do something different. There are two things that she wants to do. So, number one is she wants to go to Disney World, which is fine, you know, I wouldn't mind going. that's the first thing she wants to do. She knows somebody that could get us in for free, and then all we would have to do is just, you know, worry about whatever we're going to buy in there and stuff like that. Number two, she wants to go Black Friday shopping. For those that don't know what Black Friday shopping is, it's the day after Thanksgiving where everything you can possibly imagine is dramatically reduced. There are people that sleep outside. I mean, they eat they eat the Thanksgiving dinner, and then they go sleep outside of a Best Buy all night until Friday comes around. And then when the door opens, everyone kind of stampedes inside and just fucking... It's like the Hunger Games. All of a sudden, people are just fucking fighting to the death over a fucking Xbox, you know? Yeah, so my sister wants to do that. I told her we're gonna have to, you know, we're gonna have to have a little powwow, and, we gotta figure out what exactly it is we want to buy. I know my sister wants a digital camera. She wants a good one. She likes to get... she's not really much into electronics. Like, she doesn't know what to get, you know? She's kind of one of those people that doesn't do research. And I think you have to do research on electronics, especially if it's something you really want. You gotta know what you're buying, you know? You just can't get the first thing that the salesperson is telling you to buy. So, I know she wants a good camera. She's always been stuck with a bum camera. She always does this. She always, she and I have, like, this little competitive thing from little. We've always had that. Where I want something, she'll, you know, has to one-up me. So, if I want a camera, she'll go out and get the camera first. But it just so happens that the camera she always gets, or whatever she always gets first before me, happens to be something, you know, that's not good. And then I'll take my time, and then eventually I'll get what I really want. So, I mean, I tend to always get what I want, so so that's what happens. But yeah, she's stuck with this awful camera, and I have this very, very good camera. I have like one of those Nikon touchscreens and high def cameras. It's really, really good. And so that's what she wants. She wants like one of those nice touchscreen new cameras. I think I know the camera I want to get. I want to get it for her. You know, my sister has always flipped the bill for me and a lot of things. She's always given me things. You know, I wasn't working for a long time, and I've always been broke. I've been broke for a long time. So it's just been me. So, you know, whenever she can, she throws me a little bone and gets me things. She doesn't have to, and I feel so bad when she does. But she does, and, you know, I'm blessed now that I can be able to return the favor, so I'm gonna get her a camera. I know that she wants a laptop, a new one. The one she has, it's been giving her problems. The fan is, you know, burnt out. She's had to change that. The battery, she has to change the battery numerous times. It's really slow. It's really big and bulky and overheats a lot, so... yeah, she wants a new laptop. I can't afford a new laptop for her. but although Black Friday, they dramatically reduced the prices, so you could get away with a nice laptop for a good $300 or something, like a really good one, so it's possible, but I'm not going to jump the gun yet. So, the camera definitely I would get for her. What do I want? I want a new radio. I've been wanting a radio for the longest time. I've always had a radio in my house. Radios are good for me because it's always, it's therapeutic. I have... music is therapeutic to me. I love my music. I listen to lots of things, but mostly I listen to, you know, very dance music, trance music, hardcore, hardstyle, yeah, Europop, all that stuff. So, but yeah, I listen to a lot of things. I have a very eclectic taste. I love doo-wop, I love, you know, all kinds of music, so. Yep, so radio is definitely something that I want. I had a radio that my sister got me, apparently, and my ex-husband put up a shelf, and he's not very handy. He's not handy at all. Usually things that he builds or puts together break before the year is over, so he put a shelf, he put my radio on it. The shelf didn't have any anchors or anything. It couldn't support the weight of the radio. And so one day, the shelf collapsed. And of course it fell with the radio, and it fell in a way that the radio just kaput. I think I didn't get to 2 months with that radio. It's so sad. And I love my radio. I had like an iPod dock and it was just great. I had like a nice CD player. I have a bunch of burnt CDs. And now I have no radio. It's just depressing because it's so quiet. Usually I like to have the radio on all the time. If I'm cleaning, if I'm by myself, it's just really nice. And it's always like, I don't feel so alone with that noise in the background, you know? So, yeah, I definitely need a radio. I've been looking on eBay. There's a radio that I like. I've been this close to getting it. I always go to eBay and I always look at it. I always browse and I'm like, hey, I see you. And I don't know if I should get you. But now we have Black Friday coming up. And maybe I can find something a little bit better. I'm going to research a little bit and see what's out there and what I like. And I don't know what else. A Nintendo Wii, definitely. My kid wants one. My ex keeps saying he's going to get her one. But he says a lot of things. I'm not going to wait for him to get it for her. I mean, if he wants to get her one, then that's great. Then we'll just have two. But yeah, if I tell him that I'm going to get it, then he won't get it. He'll just be like, oh, well, you go get it, you know, of course. I'll just get her next time. I'll get her something. So if he wants to get her one, he can get her one. We both can. So that's something else that could be on sale. Yeah, there's a few things. I'm going to research a little bit and see what I want. That way, we have a game plan because Black Friday is scary, let me tell you. It is insanity out there. People get hurt. People get into fights. There's a limited amount of merchandise that they put out. And it's first dibs, you know. So I'm going to work out really hard that week. That way I can sprint my little gazelle ass to the aisles and grab what I can. I'm going to tell my sister the same. She's going to have to, you know, start working on her cardio. And I'm going to have plenty of pepper spray. Because sometimes you have to mace motherfuckers. And also, I'm going to... I may bring an umbrella, you know, because sometimes you gotta poke people. And the umbrella could come in handy in case there's something on a shelf that my short behind can't reach and I could just kind of, like, get it off the shelf, you know? Or I could wear very, but I'm not comfortable in heels or anything, or tall shoes. I'm scared of heights, so I can't wear big shoes. So I think the umbrella or possibly my cane could come in handy, you know? I think the cane better than the umbrella because the cane has a hook, you know, and that way if there's somebody, like, in front of me trying to grab what I could grab, then I can, like, get the hook, you know, of the cane. Kind of like what they do on stage when somebody's, like, really, like, a bad musical act or a bad comedian. They kind of bring the hook out and they pry the person off the stage. So I think the cane could come in handy because I can get the cane and kind of, like, pry the person away from, you know, my goods. So I think I'll bring the cane. So yeah, we gotta have a plan in place when we do Black Friday shopping. So I'll let you know how that goes. Hopefully I won't land in jail for beating a person because they touched my radio. So whatever. But yeah, that's what she wants to do. I don't know about the Disney World thing. I think that it's gonna take a lot of our time, a lot of walking, a lot of... I don't know. I mean, it sounds like a good idea. We'll see what happens. She wants to go, but this is... She says a lot of things. So we'll see. But yeah, I'm really excited to go up there. I really miss my family. I just want to get away right now. It's a little bit, I'm a little bit nervous going up there because, you know, we both have eating disorders and two people with eating disorders getting together is, you know, it's a little bit bad. So I'm not really, I don't know how strong my will could be there. I've been binging purging all day today. I binge purged yesterday too. I work tomorrow, so tomorrow I think I'm not going to, but I probably won't eat either. That's the thing though. I mean, I either binge purge or I don't eat. There's no happy medium, you know? You know, the times that my boyfriend has been here, I eat, but then the rest of the week I feel really bad that I ate and then I'm not eating and then it's kind of like, I feel like I'm doing damage control after he's gone. Like, oh my god, look, I've eaten, now I have to get rid of it, now I have to take laxatives, now I have to, you know, it's, there's no, there's no, there's no medium. It's either or, you know? I just can't be comfortable with eating and keeping it and okay, you know? I can't. After a while, it just bugs me. After a while, it gets to me, so. I don't know if I'm ever gonna be okay with it. I've been really sad today. I've been crying all day today. It's been coming since Tuesday that I've been kind of going down. I have been taking my medication. I haven't taken my meds in 2 days. I took it today, though. I don't know if... I got a little anxious at work sometimes. And I hate it, you know? All I can do is just... And I've already taken my anxiety meds, and all I can do at work is just kind of control my breathing and pray and just hope that I don't pass out at work or I just don't freak the fuck out, you know? Eventually it subsides. But the depression has been gradually coming on. I hate it. I hate when I get into these moods. I'm gonna kind of push everyone away and I'm kind of pain in the ass because I just want to be left alone and... You know, people don't understand that. They want you to just feel better and feel happy. And yeah, that sounds great, you know. I want that too, but I can't explain. I can't explain what depression is like, real depression. People are like, oh, because I feel bad, I'm depressed today. No, you're just in a bad mood or you're just having a bad day. You know, you have a reason for feeling upset or something. Like, I have no reasons to feel that way. I just do. It's just something that it comes on and it just stays with me and it just escalates and escalates and escalates and eventually it just leads me down this bad path where I'm in a really bad place and I just don't really, like, I really don't care, you know. So I haven't got that bad in a long time. I hope that I don't ever get like that. I feel like each time the depression bouts come on, I'm getting a little bit more and more closer to that place. And it's scary, you know. So I see my doctor next Monday. I'm gonna have a talk with him. It's a new doctor, I don't know. I hate that they're always switching doctors on me because, you know, they don't know you and they just have your paperwork, you know. You're not a person, you're just next, you know, you're just the next customer in line. So I don't know, I wanted to tell them, you know, I want my fears to be heard, I want someone to really listen to what I'm saying. I think maybe I want my medication to be, like, the dosage to be upped, and I'm hoping that the new doctor can agree and be like, okay, well, let's try that, you know, let's try it. Or I don't want someone trying to talk me out of something, like, listen to what I'm saying and let's come to an agreement, you know, let's agree on this. Let's try this out together, you know. I don't want someone telling me, oh, you'll get over it, or you'll feel better, or do that. I don't need to hear that. Trust me, if there was a way to feel better without any of this, then I would have been there already. But that's not how it goes, you know. So sometimes I just get frustrated because I know people mean well. Everyone means well, I know, and I appreciate it. I'm glad, you know. That it could be the other extreme where nobody cares. That's... You know, I'm glad that people care about me and I'm glad people are worried for me, but I don't, how could I put this without it sounding bad, God, like, I hear what you're saying, but I don't hear what you're saying, like, I don't want to hear it, because I feel like the more you tell me something, it's like you're challenging me, you know, and I don't like that. I don't like to be challenged. That's my phone. So I don't know, like, I hear what you're saying. I know you want me to get better, I know you want me to feel better and stuff like that, but it's not gonna happen just because you say so, you know. Like, you have to understand that I'm voicing my feelings, I'm voicing how I'm feeling. Like, I want empathy. That's what I want. I don't want somebody to feel sorry for me. I want someone to try to put themselves in my position, put themselves in my place, and be like, you know something, I would feel like that too, or, you know, I'm so sorry you feel like that. And, you know, I don't want somebody to give me an example, like, oh, watch a movie, or go eat some ice cream, or go do something, or take a shower, or, you know, you're gonna feel better. Like, Maybe that works for some people, but that doesn't work for me, you know? I'm not there. I have serious issues, you know? That doesn't help. That doesn't help me. That just makes me want to push everyone. That's why I push people away when I get really, really depressed, because I just don't want to hear it. And I don't want people to feel bad for me, or I don't want to scare anybody. And so, like, my sister knows better. My sister called me today, and she heard the way I was, and she's like, "Are you taking your medicines? You know, did you take your pill today?" I'm like, "Yeah, I did." And she's like, "Well, what's, like, you know, tell the doctor, tell, you know, you need help, you need, you know, just try to take a nap, try to, you know." Like, she knows already that there's nothing that she can say that's going to make me change the way I feel. So she kind of just gives me my space, which is good sometimes. But sometimes I need that. Because the more you suggest things, the more it doesn't help, and it just makes me frustrated, because I feel like I can't get my point across. So, but yeah, I just hope the doctor and I can come to something, you know, and maybe that can help me feel a little bit better. I don't know. But I don't like feeling like this. I don't like crying all day for no reason. I don't like feeling hopeless, and I don't like sleeping all day, and I don't like feeling like I don't want to care anymore about myself or anything or anybody, and I don't want to be self-destructive and stuff like that. So we'll see what happens. So I don't know what else I can tell you guys. I as much as work is frustrating, I am looking forward to work tomorrow, if you can believe that. Probably because I get to get out the house, and I don't know, I get to be distracted for a little bit. And then I kind of just get to, I don't know, be on like autopilot for a little bit. I don't have to think so much when I'm at work. I just kind of have to do, you know, I have things that I have to do. I don't really have to think and feel a whole lot of things. So I'm kind of looking forward to that. Tomorrow's going to be a very long day for me, like 8 hours or so. And I'm going to be distracted. And then by the time I get home, I'm going to be wired a little bit. And then I'm going to try to go to sleep. And it's going to be like that for a few days. And I'm actually looking forward to that. I know by Wednesday I'll be exhausted a little bit, but I'm hoping that by Wednesday I'll feel a little bit better. Maybe all this distraction will help me. And that's what I need sometimes. I'm sorry if I'm so distant lately with some of you. But I'm just really not in a good place right now. I don't want to trigger anybody. I don't want to bring anybody down. So I kind of just keep to myself. I feel like I don't have anything positive to say. I feel like you could tell me something happy and I'm just gonna counteract with something negative. So I don't wanna make anyone feel bad. Everyone's suggestions are fantastic and wonderful. I'm grateful, but I'm just not in that happy place right now. I'm in a really bad place right now. My eating disorder is really bad right now. I'm just really frustrated. I'm just so tired of this thing. I'm so tired of it never being enough. I'm so tired of never feeling like I'm enough. Like, I'm getting so tired of not being able to get my point across. I'm getting so tired of not being able to really say what I mean, like what I feel. Like, I hold a lot of things back, you know? I can never be really honest. Although I come close, but I mean, I don't think I've ever been really, really honest when it comes to my eating disorder with anyone, because I feel alone in this thing. And although I have all you wonderful people reading and watching, and that's great, I'm happy for that, but I don't have anyone in real life close to me that I feel like I could really open up with, you know? Sometimes I wish I had a therapist again, and I think maybe I could open up to a stranger, because it's not someone that I know that won't judge me, or someone that could give me maybe like fresh perspective, you know? Sometimes I need that too. So, but yeah, I feel like I hold a lot back. I'm not really that trusting yet. Mostly because I feel like there won't be any resolution. Like, no matter how honest I can be with someone, they can never understand. And they can't help me. So, what's the point, you know? Sometimes I feel like that. It's not a good way to feel, but there you have it. So, let's change the subject. I have finished watching Cake Boss, which was great. My daughter actually loved that show. I think I'm going to try to call sometime next week to see if I can get basic cable, because my kid is just so bored here and I feel so bad for her. So, basic cable TV. I don't know how much more it's going to cost. We'll see. I have started watching Charmed on Netflix. Charmed with the witches. The Hallowell sisters, with Shannon Doherty and Alyssa Milano, and I forget what the other girl's name is. I think it's Holly Marie Combs or something. And yeah, I've been starting to watch that, so something to watch. And that's it. I'm gonna finish watching that and finish my wine and then go to bed. So I hope you all are doing well. The work week again tomorrow. Let's see what happens. So enjoy your Sunday and we'll talk again next week. I'll try to blog during the week, and forgive me if I don't, or forgive my shitty post. I feel like I've gotten very boring. So that's it. Goodbye, everybody. Good night.